We're here. We got a big moment coming, right? And it's my honor to be part of it. Well, I do have my work cut out for me because I'm presenting one of the most prolific women in showbiz. Yes. Kristen is an Emmy and Tony award-winning actor. With her unbelievable range as a singer and an actor, she dazzles in comedies, musicals, and dramas, swinging from one genre with ease and compassion and amazement. Truly, though, I'm proud to be presenting any award to Kristen Chenoweth, anything I'll present her with, but an honor from the game-changing organization New York Wiki, and one that celebrates women speaking their minds, being their most authentic selves, and spreading the message of women's empowerment. Now that is a perfect fit. And as my friend, Miss Allie Love, by the way, awesome last name. Nobody's mentioned Love is your last name. What a perfect, it's real. Said in her introduction, I am the CEO and president of the LGBTQ advocacy organization, GLAAD. We work every day to shape culture, to grow acceptance. And each year we recognize an ally who uses their platform to advocate for our community. In 2011, before marriage equality was the law of the land, and our allies were often hesitant to be visible, we were lucky enough to honor Kristen with our Vanguard Award. And she still speaks out constantly, using her platform to change hearts and minds. As a person of strong faith, Kristen has taken a special and critical angle when it comes to her advocacy work. She speaks honestly to the blending of two things that many people don't feel can live in harmony, but truly do: deep faith and acceptance of all people. Talk about a rule breaker, right? That's a rule breaker. Whether speaking truth to power with her own story or advocating for marginalized communities, breast cancer awareness, Broadway Cares, animal welfare, and so many other causes, she makes a better, stronger, and more unified world. Especially in today's divisive and often dangerous political climate, we need allies to join with us. Kristen is always first in line to do so, and she inspires countless women everywhere to do the same. Most recently, when an LGBTQ young person in Oklahoma tragically lost their life, Kristen immediately reached out to the family, offering love, and she reached out to us at GLAAD to help end discrimination that too many queer students face. She leads with her heart, with kindness, with humor, and a warmth that is truly and uniquely her own. Tonight, we'll hear a lot about women using their voices, but Kristen's actually, her voice is unmistakable. Her original music and her unforgettable performances have spoken to the hearts of millions. Wicked was a sensation, but it was only one moment in her vast career on stage and screen. From Pushing Daisies, West Wing, Glee, to her new musical that you must run to, not walk, The Queen of Versailles, her cultural and artistic impact have cemented her as one of the most prolific artists and performers of all time. Kristen is a case study in the power of art to change lives. Her work makes us laugh, cry, and even believe that a woman can really use a bubble as a mode of transportation. That surely would save us a lot of hassle when trying to find parking on these streets. She is, without question, an icon, and it's always an honor to be in her orbit. Before we invite her on stage, let's hear a few words from the woman herself.
The best rule break of all is be yourself. Everybody else is taken. Don't tell me what I can't do. Let me show you what I can do. That has been my mantra ever since I can remember. People have a tendency to think about me, Kristen Chenoweth, that I'm rainbow, unicorn, and glitter. I take the good that people say, and the negative I delete. Delete, delete, delete. My drive comes from a spiritual place. I believe music is speech on pitch. I have something to say, so therefore I sing it. The world inspires me of what I want to do next. If you listen hard enough and you are quiet, you can hear what you're to do. Be a student. Don't be afraid to keep learning and evolving and growing, because why else are we here? Kindness will get you so far in life. I love to let other people shine. That's my favorite thing. I'm getting better with age. I want to do this for a long time, as long as I'm allowed.
Please welcome to the stage the one, the only, Kristen Chenoweth. I wanna do something that matters, say something different, something that sets the whole world on its ear. I wanna do something better with the time I was given. I wanna try to touch a few hearts in this life, leave nothing less.
First off, I would like to thank the person who is responsible for the height of this podium. I'm so happy I can see over it. Sometimes it doesn't work out that way. Sarah Kate Ellis, you know, I'm lucky to be able to call her my friend. I want to say I can see in the future you getting up here and accepting one of these for everything that you've done for GLAAD, and I'm so proud to know you, frankly. Thank you. I also just want to thank the Matrix Awards, the other honorees, y'all's speeches tonight, even the presenter people, even that one man, like, you're so good, sir. You are. And all of their speeches, Nina, oh my gosh, your pants with the tuxedo stripe, like everybody is amazing. I'm not that fancy. I probably won't use fancy words, and I'm not even going to use the teleprompter, except for right now. I have a lot of great women on my team. Jill Fritzo, my long-suffering publicist. Melody Young, who does the Jennifer, like the Citibank. She's my money person, and I know math is very important, and I'm sure it helps a lot of things in the world, but thank God for Melody Young. My assistant, Shannon McKay, who inspires me to be more woke and tells me I'm doing all right. Jess Froman, my lawyer. Jenny, Lindsay, and Maddie at the Gorilla Girls that help me do my social media. Mary Mitchell Campbell, who is my conductor and sister wife. She's actually my non-sexual life partner. She's my conductor, she's my music director, and she's my sister. And then tonight I have, of course, my manager, who flew across the country to be here tonight for me, Mr. Troy Zion. Thank you so much, Troy, for you're a single dad to two wonderful teenage daughters, and you're killing it. And I thank you for entering this room with mostly estrogen again. Thank you. Yes, please. To the scholarship winners, so I have a Broadway boot camp, Kristen Chenoweth Broadway boot camp. In my hometown, They told me that they were going to name the. They were somebody died and left our hometown a lot of money. I'm glad they did because all we ever had was football and Sonic. Football and Sonic. And they told me that they were going to name the theater after me. And I said, oh no, I'm too young. And they said, you're not. Why are y'all laughing? Anyway, I've gotten to know, you know, I've got these kids from 13 to 18 that I work with every summer. And I see them grow. And what I'm seeing now is the fruits of my hard labor are coming to pass. I just recently cast one of my camp kids in my new upcoming Broadway show. And that not because she was my kid at camp, because she deserved it. And she went and auditioned and won the role on her own. But I really want to speak to you young girls for 1 second. There's going to be so many no's, okay? It's okay to get no's. I guarantee you all the women tonight that are getting this award have been told no over and over. It's just how you handle the no, and sometimes you can get around a no by going a different way. There's also going to be people that tell you negative. You can't do that. You shouldn't do that. You're too wrong, skinny, short, tall, whatever. No. So I meant what I said. I delete that, and I even use my finger. So do it with me now. Delete. Okay, say it with me. Everybody, in fact. Okay, good. First rule break of my life, third grade in the Bible Belt, little Christian girl. I walked to school with a girl named Jackie Bell. We were friends until we got the same coat at Target, and then it wasn't funny anymore, but... we were walking to school, and when we got to school, it was the first time I heard the word dyke. Someone yelled dyke to my friend Jackie, and I came home. I said, Jackie, what does that mean? She said, ignore it. Third grade. And I go to my mom. I said, Mama, what does dyke mean? She said, we don't use that word. I said, but what does it mean? And she said, it's when two girls like each other. I said, like me and Jackie? She said, no, more. And I'm lucky because I was adopted into a family in the southern Bible Belt that said, we will never judge. We will only love. And God loves us all the same. So I promptly went to school and told Charlie Carr, don't you be mean to my friend. Don't you be mean to my friend Jackie Bell. And I might have threatened him, but rule break number one. Rule break number two, moving to New York and auditioning for a Broadway musical. My agent said you shouldn't do that. They're looking for a tall, leggy chorus girl who can sing a high C. I said, yeah, but they haven't met me. And my agent almost looked at me and laughed. And I said, that's okay, I'll go to the cattle call. And I went. I knew I wasn't tall. I knew I didn't have a high C. I had a high E flat. But anyway... By me breaking the rule, and this is again to my young girls, by me breaking the rule, they decided to change the whole character. So they just changed the part. I'm just saying, you don't know until you try. And there's going to be a lot of no's. I get them still. I was, not to name drop, but Reese Witherspoon is a good friend of mine, and she said, you know, I got told no. And I said, I know what you mean. I got told no too. We're still all being told no, but we're going to be, soon it's going to be our yes. We just got to keep at it and keep at it and keep at it. And like the women have all talked tonight, how they've gotten there. It's so inspiring to listen to. And I've been honestly sitting over there taking notes on my iPhone. I'm really, really honored to be included in such an illustrious group. I also really loved my cauliflower steak. I want to say thank you to the chef. And I just want to, you know, I want to leave you. I'm not a great public speaker. I'm a singer. I'm an actor. I hide behind a lot of roles. So I just ask that as we leave this event tonight, there's been so, I'm not a political person and I'm not going to do it, not going to do it. But I am going to say, in our world right now, it feels like there's so much more that we're divided on. And I beg us to look at each other and come together, even with a smile, a greet, even if you disagree, meet each other with love, not hate, because then evil wins, right? And sounds very Pollyanna for me to say that. But if you can wake up and give each other a smile, even when you feel like complete crap, it can help your day. And I leave you with this. Smile, though your heart is aching. Smile, even though it's breaking. When there are clouds in the sky, you'll get by if you smile through your tears and sorrow. Smile, and maybe tomorrow you'll see the sun come shining through for you. Light up your face with gladness. Hide every trace of sadness. Although a tear may be ever so near, that's the time you must keep on trying. Smile, what's the use of crying? You'll find that life is still worthwhile if you just smile. Thank you. God bless you.